Phantom and Studios here from Nerf Cutting Studios Star Wars Edition episode. Today we're going to be making something that comes out of Jabba the Hutt called Jabba Slime. And of course, I think you guys already know how to make slime, but for the guys who don't, you need glue, teaspoon and tablespoon, food coloring, bowl, contact lens solution, baking soda, and that's basically it. Okay, start by pouring around 1/4 cup of PVA glue into a bowl. PVA glue contains polyvinyl acetate, a chemical made up of molecule chains, which is perfect for making slime. Well, we're just going to be using this glue, the Elmer's school glue, because PVA glue is just what they call it inside the book. As you can probably tell, this glue doesn't have that much in there, so make sure you get one that is completely full, because mine doesn't have that much in there, easily, as you can see. So that's all my glue. I just wasted my entire bottle of glue. I'm going to buy some more for my next crafter or something. Add 1/4 of a teaspoon of baking soda to the PVA glue. Baking soda is also known as sodium bicarbonate or bicarbonate of soda, and is used to make cakes, pancakes, and bread. A teaspoon of baking soda. There we go. That's how much baking soda you need. Next, mix the glue and baking soda together with a spoon. Stir the mixture thoroughly to make sure that it is smooth. Keep stirring until all the lumps have disappeared. We're going to use this teaspoon to stir it up. I want to tell you about some upcoming events while I'm stirring this stuff up. I was thinking, since our iPad has a ton of storage now, we were thinking of using the iPad to record our mini multiplayer contest. and on the way to Rockville to meet our, to see our grandma, to see our grandparents. And I was thinking of making a video so you guys can watch us compete. Now we do get, we usually do rewards for this. So yeah, I think you'll have a fun time watching this. To make your slime more Jabba-like, stir through a few drops of green food coloring until it's mixed fully. The more green food coloring you use, the greener the slime. Now that makes, you can't add too much food coloring or else it won't look like Jabba the Hutt's. I'm just gonna do 3 drops. As you can see, I put the drops are in separately. Starting to look slime yet? Hope so. Add 1 tablespoon of contact lens solution to the green liquid. This acts as the cross-linking chemical. Keep on stirring the mixture until it firms up and turns into a glob of slime. Hold on, I'm trying to get this off. Oh gosh, it's already sticky. Okay, hold on. Okay, I think I did not make Jabba slime. Instead, I made blue Gungan slobber, which is basically the blue slime that is recommended in this. That is described in this, I think. If your slime looks and feels too sticky, you can add more contact lens solution to the mixture. When it is ready, remove the glob from the mixing container. Now you can play with your slime. After you finish, store the slime in an Arlek container, throw it away. Then make sure you wash your hands thoroughly. So that is how you make your slime, Star Wars-like slime. So if you have actual green food coloring that doesn't turn it into blue Gungan slobber, like mine did, it can turn out to be like actual Jabba slime. Or you can make it into different colors. If you turn it to orange, you can turn it to orange and yellow Ranthar tentacle goo. Or you have yellow and green, you can do glitter Diagonga slime. So I chose the blue Gungan slobber by accident because it was blue. My green food coloring does not look that green, does it? No, so that's our slime video. I'll see you guys next time.